Are you an old school gamer? Or do you like that new shit? Alright guys, it's Henry Padilla here again with the Social Team. We're back with episode number 4 of Local Love. Today we're actually at one of my favorite places lately, New Game Plus. Over here, it's a play-by-the-hour gaming lounge, and they have a huge variety of things to do here from A to Z. I'm talking retro games, to VR, to PCs, to board games, card games, literally anything that you could think of and anything that is your taste, pretty sure they got it here. This is gonna be a really fun one for us to do, guys. I'm really excited about this one, so let's get into it. At New Game Plus with both of the owners, Ariel and John. Mm-hmm. Thank you guys so much for having us out here today.
Sure.
Like I said in the intro, this is a place that I'm really loving a lot lately, probably because I live across the street and the environment here is really, really awesome. So I just wanted to, you know, kind of put that out there of like, you know, how did you guys even start this place? When did you start this place? You know, what was the motive?
Well, so we started last year in 2020. And we thought it would be a really good idea to have a business complementary to our video game store next door. And, you know, selling games is one thing, but having a place to play them is another. Yeah. And it sort of made sense to sort of, you know, have a complementary business model, not just an expansion, but something that really built on the back of people who buy them.
Video game nights, or like game nights, was something that we did a lot at the store next door as well. And I know that for many years, that was something we had talked about, was like, how cool would it be if we had an arcade and like a dedicated space that we could, you know, have people get together instead of like filling up a retail space, but like having a place where really people could come and have community and play games and do that, where that's the only thing that happened there.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that's something really big that you guys are creating here, is a community. It makes me realize it's a lot more than video games. It's like, hey, you know, these are awesome people that you can kind of like hang out with throughout the day. Every day you guys are open, right?
From 2 to 10.
2 to 10, yeah. So the accessibility to be able to come here and be able to, like, you know, relieve some stress, talk to some buddies, just hang out, chill, right? Like, people come here, right? They don't even play games sometimes. They just...
Sometimes it's just the social nature of being someplace where you're welcome, you're comfortable, you're familiar, and getting people sort of out and about, especially after a year of pandemic. Mm-hmm. It's really nice to have a place where you can go socialize safely and do it, something you enjoy, have a wide variety of things to choose from. But yeah, sometimes people just come and literally hang out with us. Mm-hmm. And that's great to me. You know, yeah. I want people to feel like they have a place to be.
Yeah. 100%.
People have called this their Cheers a couple times.
Yeah.
We have the same people who will regularly come in here and play the specific games that they play. And
yeah, we know people by name. You know, they come in and, yeah, Woody Harrelson's a regular. It's great.
Yeah, it's
yeah,
great.
He shows up.
Yeah.
I think what's great is that video games are important to different people for different reasons. And we wanted to create like an all-inclusive environment, a family-friendly environment, a people-friendly environment that was a space for, you know, for everybody to really be welcome. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 100%. You guys are definitely doing that. You guys kind of went against the grain too, because you guys just started in the middle of a pandemic.
Yeah.
For the awesome reason of community, right? So when did you guys actually open up?
So we opened in October of last year, 2020, and our original plan was literally, we'd signed our contract to get this place going in February of last
year. Okay.
And so, you know, we're gonna blitz this place, we're gonna get ready all the way through March, and then of course the world shuts down and that throws off everything into our plan.
Yeah.
And so we were able to push it back only so far before ultimately saying, I think October, we feel safe enough to be able to accommodate for all the proper state mandates and measures for safety, for comfort, for, you know, all the right reasons. But you know, we were pressed for time ultimately. We just wanted to do it right. And so we were limited in capacity, we were limited in space, we were limited with a couple of things, but.
Yeah, many people have asked a few times, like, why did you open during a pandemic? And it's like, well, we weren't trying to.
Exactly.
That wasn't the plan. And originally we had hoped to be open in April, but mm-hmm. that didn't happen. And
yeah.
So we've been very fortunate, I think, to to weather the pandemic surprisingly well, considering the circumstances. Mm-hmm.
That's definitely good. And I really love seeing that stuff too, because it's just like, you know, the only way is up from here. You know, it's just like if you can do it in this sense of environment, like that's ultimately like, it's a badass thing. Like truly, it's really a badass thing. And that's why like, I applaud you guys for doing that. And I mean, like we all mentioned earlier, it was just like, just having a place where community is just a world positive thing. Mm-hmm. And I really, really, really enjoy that. So how would you guys kind of like, deliver advice to other people, you know, that are possibly struggling right now or thinking of creating a business? Mm-hmm. Is it just like, you know, hey, should I go all in? Should I really evaluate the logistics of things? Like, how did you guys get over the hump of going all in?
Well, we're really fortunate to have had built community for so long prior. We've got a really good support group. Gamers Anonymous has been around for over a decade. And so to have sort of piggybacked off of that was absolutely a large part of it, because a lot of the community events that we did over there transferred to things over here. But a lot of it is, again, unbridled passion for what we do, for giving to the community who gives to us. You know, without the community, our stores couldn't survive, and finding a way to love doing that genuinely. Because I can tell you right now, running a business already is tough. Running a business during a pandemic is extra hard. And if it weren't for the fact that I love doing this so much, I don't know if I can handle it. I'll be totally honest. You really have to genuinely love it. They say, you know, if you love what you do, you don't work a day in your life. Mm-hmm. And I love what I do, and it's work, but it's work that I love. So I think it's the passion for seeing people smile, for seeing people walk in, for seeing people react to what we've put together. Part of the reward is simply people walking in and smiling. You know, like there's nothing better than when people walk in that back room, man.
They're like, what is this?
The responses have been all across the board, but they're all exactly what we want.
So going back to the thing back there, so they actually have an awesome retro room. So if you could kind of explain all of the things you got going on here.
What I was going to say though, and it connects to that, is in terms of giving advice, is trust yourself. Mm-hmm. Because there was a few times in designing this place that, and it pertains to that back room especially, where we had gotten a designer who came in and really is part of why this place looks so well, looks as good as it does. And he had had a very different idea for what to do with that back room, and we debated a lot whether or not we should make it look like that or what we should do. And John and I talked a lot about this idea of the retro living room, which was really, you know, John's like, well, I wanted to do this for a long time, but how do we do this? And, you know, we have these arcade machines, or, you know, this is the other design. And we really went back and forth a lot between like what we really wanted to do, which was the far more difficult endeavor, which is what we went with, than just like, you know, the design of the couple arcade machines and the pinball machine or whatever. And having decided to go with our, you know, believing in the real, like, this is, you know, it's worth it to put in the time and the effort to design that dream idea has been like the star area of the shop, you know. And it's worth it to just, you know, believe in the idea in your head, believe in yourself and in your dreams, and what, trust yourself. Because you know, you know, and sometimes people might come in and be like, no, try this. And I'm not saying don't listen to people, but really believe in yourself. Yeah. Trust yourself. You know what the right thing to do is.
Yeah, 100%. And you guys definitely went in with that, because that's like a show-stopping area. So
thank you.
I love that. Everybody loves that part. But yeah, so what are all the specific things that you guys are offering? I mentioned it a little bit in the intro, but...
So yeah, I mean, essentially it's a pay-by-the-hour gaming lounge where you come in and you have access to all of the things that we've set up for you. So we went all in buying nice computers, getting PS4s, PS5s, Xbox One, Switches, a wide variety of games. We've got Rock Band, we've got retro games, we've got board games and card games. And essentially for that hourly fee, you get access to all of it at any point. And you can, you know, change your mind and play five different things in an hour if you so desired. You just, we want people to come in and like just try things, be experimental. You know, the mystery of walking into like an old rental store when you were a kid was you pick something and you hope that it's something you want for the whole weekend, right?
Yeah.
But over here, we want people to just, you know, comfort is great. Play a game you're familiar with, but also like don't be afraid just to throw something on you've never tried before, because there could be like an untapped interest you simply never knew about. And I've seen it happen with several people. And it's great for people to try something and then come back for the next week and play only that. It's been really cool.
Exactly. You're getting like the people that are only into shooting games and then put them into like solo story games
and
something of that sort.
Precisely. Yeah.
So that's really, really awesome. I mean, the whole environment, everything that you guys got going on here, it's super awesome. And even I think just 1 hour is only $5?
It starts at $5. Time gets put onto an account, and the time only gets spent as you play. So people can buy multiple hours and then use them over a long period of time. And the more hours you buy, the bigger the discount is. So we encourage people to come in and sort of try it out and get a feel for the place. And then usually they'll buy the big hour packages, and then over the next week or so, they'll just come in every day.
Awesome. So, awesome, guys. Yeah. Well, I really appreciate you guys having us out here. Like I said, this place is awesome. For $5 an hour, you can get access to all this stuff, or you could pay, like, what is it, $500 for a PS5, or however much they're going for.
You can get one for $500.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yeah, exactly. So you're getting access to a lot, guys. It's a community. You're getting a lot of friendly people, owners that they even said so. They've loved the heck out of this. They love doing it for you guys. So definitely come out here and check them out. I appreciate you guys so much.
Yeah, man.
Awesome, guys.
Absolutely.
Well, we
Thank
will
you.
See
we
you guys
you.
At the next one. Thank you guys so much.
Take care.